What is up? Today's episode is all about how to burn belly fat, that stubborn, annoying belly fat that just won't go away no matter what you do. We're gonna cover exactly how to get rid of it today. Let's go. So belly fat, it usually is in the headlines of pretty much every fat loss pill or potion or body wrap or supplement or program. Burning belly fat is something we all want. Why? Because it's natural for us to want a healthy looking body. And our eyes tend to be attracted towards the center of bodies, which abs and a toned stomach are the national, or I should say worldwide, symbol for being fit. So body fat in general is something that we want to target. We want to get rid of the excess belly fat, the excess body fat that we carry, for number one, health reasons, right? The more body fat we store, the more health issues we can experience, including disease, including high blood pressure, diabetes, cancer, the list goes on and on. Plus, our quality of life just isn't as good when we're carrying around a lot of excess tissue. If you think about it, if you're carrying around 45 to 60 pounds of body fat, it feels like carrying around a small person. It can really wear you down. It can destroy your energy. But belly fat is our big desire, right? Belly fat, getting rid of belly fat, is what we all want to do. We all want to have that sculpted midsection. So how do we do it? Well, let me tell you, number one, you cannot target belly fat. Belly fat is not something that you can choose to burn on a daily basis. In fact, anything that tells you that they can target belly fat directly and help you eliminate specific areas of fat on your body, it's a lie. It's a complete and total bullshit myth, all right? So don't believe it. Don't believe the pills or the body wraps or the waist trainers and all that nonsense. It's honestly 100% BS. Anybody who claims differently is a liar and should be put out of business. Real talk. So what they're trying to sell you on is your desire to get rid of that unwanted stomach fat, because usually for most people, the belly and the hips and the general middle of the body is the hardest place for you to lose fat. And there's a reason behind that. The midsection is one of the most important areas of the body, and it should be protected at all times, because that's where our organs are stored, that's where our stomach is stored, our heart is right in the center of our chest, and women carry children in their stomach area. So it makes sense that we'd want to have a lot of insulation and protection in that area. And the body's not going to want to just get rid of it just because you want a toned six pack. So forget about all the BS that you've been told. You cannot target belly fat with doing a million crunches. You can't target belly fat by taking a specific pill or supplement. And you definitely can't target belly fat by wrapping your waist in some kind of waist trainer or plastic wrap. That is complete BS. So ignore that. Here's how you can target belly fat. Number one, you have to understand that belly fat is going to come off over time, depending on your genetics, right? Some of us are wired to store more fat in that area and also wired to not get rid of fat in that area. So I know, personally speaking, I have a hard time losing belly fat. I have to really dial down my nutrition and get super lean to have a clear set of abs. Sucks to be me, right? But at the end of the day, most guys and women are like that, right? Some of us are blessed with a lean body and we have no problem keeping a lean stomach, and good for you guys. Screw you guys, by the way. No, just kidding. But anyway, how do we lose belly fat? Well, we just lose fat in general, right? We are patient. We diet off and we train off the body fat, right? We burn more calories than we take in. And over time, that belly fat that we despise is eventually going to go away. We also want to make sure that our routine is set up to give us success with losing belly fat. And that means focusing on weight training. So training for strength, training your entire body, not just doing upper body, but making sure you're training your legs, your back, your shoulders, your calves, your abs, right? And I'll get to abs in a second, but we want to make sure that we're giving appropriate amount of time to all of our body parts so that we're building a strong base in all parts of our body to make sure that your entire body is strong and make sure that you keep the strength. And also, number one, muscle burns more calories than any other tissue on the body. So it's important to have a quality amount of muscle so that your metabolism, the need for the calories that you're taking in, is increased, right? So you can get away with eating a little bit more food while torching belly fat and body fat. The next thing we want to do is we want to make sure our nutrition plan is sustainable. We don't want to starve ourselves and try to burn off all the fat in a month, right? It's going to take some time. So have a plan that you can see yourself doing for a long period of time. Don't be tempted by the nonsense that tells you you can get ripped in 14 days or 21 days. That's old news. That doesn't work. We already know that. If it did work, we'd all be walking around super ripped because everybody can stick to a diet for a couple weeks, right? But belly fat comes with the time and the consistency that's put in to your nutrition and your training plan. So stick with a nutrition plan that's sustainable. Live in a calorie deficit that's just a few hundred calories less than what you burn, so you don't feel completely starved all the time. Also, when it comes to training your abs, so it does make sense actually to have a training plan built for your abs. It's going to increase your ab definition. And what I mean by that is we want to train our abs the same way we train our arms or our back or our shoulders or our legs. We want to give our abs resistance, right? We want to train with weight. We want to make sure that we're strengthening our core. And that way, as we lean down, it becomes easier to see your abs because they're bigger, right? They have more tissue now because you've strengthened them and they've grown because of it. So you don't have to be as shredded to see your abs. Like me, I used to have to get down to crazy lean levels of body fat in order to see my abs, but over the years I've trained them appropriately, and now I can see my abs all the time, even if my body fat is higher, because they're more muscular and stronger, so I can see them much easier through my skin. So that, in a nutshell, is how you burn belly fat. I know, no silly supplements, no crazy diet routine, no weird cardio plan that's gonna have you doing two-a-days, my bad. But hey, I'm just giving you the real advice. So if you love this video and it was helpful, just leave me a comment below and be sure to subscribe to the channel. We're in the midst of a 30-day challenge where we're putting out 30 videos in 30 days. So there's gonna be a lot of quality content. Subscribe so you don't miss a single video. That's all I got. If you need coaching, if you need more help, everything is in the description of the video below. I'm out. Peace.